Okay, so let's just get started. So, a little about I'm going to start with a little bit of my average sales. When I first started, I knew within a couple days that me throwing up a graphic was not going to work. And it made me feel ugly, it made me feel spammy. I was annoyed by myself when I posted a graphic. So I knew that that was not going to be the way that I was going to do my business. So I was like, okay, like when I think of something that I want to see or that I want to buy, like what makes me attracted to that? And I kept coming back to the same thing. And that same thing was seeing someone in the product, seeing someone wearing it. If there's a top that I want to see, or I'm like, oh, I don't know how that would really look on. What's going to get me to buy that? Seeing somebody in it. And right? So, let's go back to fear real quick. So a lot of fear when we start, I mean, trying something new is scary. Just hands down, it just is. And especially I think starting a direct sales business is even a little bit scarier because there's this stigma attached to direct sales that they don't work, right? We hear that a lot, that they don't work, that all direct sales reps are annoying, that they're spammy, they're pushy, and I mean, who wants to be that? You know, like you don't want to be that, but this is the thing, okay? Anyone who views direct sales reps as that have not been in front of someone who has branded themselves correctly. And what is branding? Like what, like branding? What is that? I don't even know what that means, right? So your brand is you're their go-to makeup girl, right? You are their go-to makeup girl. So what are things that you can do to be that go-to makeup girl, right? Staying consistent with your posting is definitely gonna do that. Putting new creative content out there is going to add to that brand. I cannot tell you how many messages I get from girls saying like, "Oh my gosh, Ashley, like I've been thinking about joining. I'm thinking about joining your team. Like I have a friend or I know this person or yada yada yada, but I just don't like the way that they go about it." That's branding. If you are the girl who is posting graphics and just, you know, searching on Pinterest for images and just throwing them up on your page and just hopefully something sticks, that's not going to get far in the business. It's not going to get far, okay? Graphics are not going to get you anywhere, okay? But what will get you somewhere is being a part, getting behind your brand of products that you're doing. So let's talk, sorry, I went off on a tangent, but let's go back to fear, okay? Starting anything new is scary. It just is. It's terrifying. It's what if you fail? What if you know, what if people are annoyed by you? What if this? What if that? You know, there's so many what ifs that go into play that you think about when you start something, right? So one of the big things when I started that I didn't want to be is I didn't want to be annoying, okay? I didn't want to be that girl that was just constantly posting about her business and everyone was just annoyed, okay? This is how you can combat that, okay? By not being annoying, your face, you should never post about the products ever unless your face is in it. If you are doing like right now, this perfect example, okay, before and after, right? So if I'm trying to showcase the kudos, I think I posted one early this morning, right? I posted a before picture and an after picture and I talked about the kudos. That is not annoying to someone, okay? But join my team, contact me. Message me here. That gets annoying. Like people get like, oh God, here she goes asking to join her team yet. Okay, but if you brand yourself correctly, if you can get behind the products and say, hey, like this is me actually using them. I actually really do love these products. If you can get behind that, you will go so much farther in your business. You will go so much farther in your business. Okay, so another fear is, you know, just being that annoying, like that spammy person, okay? You will automatically not be spammy if it is your face and you are showing your face and showing your personal results, Okay, that is what people want to see. If you want someone to buy what you have, you got to show them how it works. You got to show them why it works so well. Why is that bottle of foundation $39? Well, because it covers every little, you know, speck and spot. Why is that concealer worth $29? Because it covers these dark under eye circles and makes them completely disappear. Because that little bottle is going to last me 7 months. And there are so many ways that you can go about that. Don't get overwhelmed with feeling like, oh my gosh, I don't know how to do this. I don't know how to do this. That is what you are here with me for. That is what this group is for, okay? I have the daily tasks, and those just kind of get you into the groove of like, how can you put together a post? For example, say you're wanting to show off the concealer, okay? Posting a picture of somebody else on your face is not going to get your concealer sold. It's not. Maybe you might get one sale, but if you really want to sell that concealer, you got to be consistent. You got to get out there, do a video, cover half of your face, cover a tattoo with it. Let me show you that. See, my concealer, I posted a video of that. I sold like 6 concealers that day with other stuff too, okay? But they did that because they're like, hey, I know her. I'm watching her do it, and I'm watching these results, and these are the results that she's getting. And it tells people, if she can get these results, then I can too. I think I can do that too. That is what sells, okay? That is what sells. That is where your sales are going to come from. So, just upon joining, you guys know, like, I am a huge no graphic person. I am so big on that. And it really, our team is so successful because they get up there. But there's a big fear factor with that. It's so easy to go to Pinterest and type in Younique concealer and take someone else's results and throw them up, right? But that's not personal. That's just, people see that and their mind registers as ad. Spam, keep going, keep scrolling. But when they see, oh wait, hey, I know that girl. Even if they just met you in a party, when your parties are pictures of you and videos of you, they know who you are. They know you, and they've connected with you, even though you guys have never even talked. I just had a girl message me the other day and tell me, oh my gosh, like, I feel like I know you. I mean, we've never talked, but I feel like I know you because of your videos. That is how people connect with you. And when people connect with you, and when you teach them something, and when you show them something, there is no room. It's not annoying. All of you girls right now who are on here have connected with me in some way. Maybe we met at an online party, or, you know, maybe, you know, your friend added you to my VIP group, but you connected with me through my videos, okay? Connecting with people and giving them something of value, that is how you sell, and that is how you build your team, and that is how you start, okay? It is scary to put a picture like this of yourself on the internet. It is, but you know what? That's why we're here. We are here because we can cheer you on, okay? All you have to do is message me and just say, Ashley, but post this before and after. Can you comment on it? Heck yeah, I'm going to comment on that. Absolutely. That's why I'm here, okay? We are here to help each other and build each other's self-confidence up. So let's talk a little bit more. If you guys have any questions too as we're going through this, or just anything, just shoot them in the comments and I'll message them. So even at an online party, you shouldn't post pics of someone else, but keep it to your own pics. Even if someone else's pictures are better. Yes, absolutely. When someone else's pictures are better, why do you think that their pictures are better than yours? And a lot of times that answer is lighting. Okay, let me show you something. All right, so I have right in front of me, I have a regular lamp with a daylight bulb screwed in. It's pitch black. It's totally dark. But look, watch what happens when I turn this off. If I take a picture like this and try to show a before and after, it's not going to work. But if I'm in good lighting, it's going to make a big difference. Lighting makes people stop and pay attention. It does. It makes people stop and pay attention. If you are like this, you're going to be like, ew, I can't even really see what's going on. And no one's going to, they're not going to do it. They're not going to pay attention. Okay. So let's go to, Trisha, to answer your question, but yes, no matter what you are posting, the deal with parties is your object with parties. Sales are like cherry on top, sprinkles on top, whipped cream. Okay. The object of parties is to expand your network because you have your friends and your family when you start. Okay. And they're probably going to buy from you a little bit here and there, but you can only sell so much to them. Okay. Think of it like this. Think if I have this drink right here. Okay. And this drink is my network. Okay. As I sell to my network, as I drink, that's going to go down until there's nothing in there, right? You have to expand your network. You've got to get a bigger bottle. You've got to get a bigger cup. In some way, shape, or form, you've got to get a bigger bottle or a bigger cup. And that's the only way that you're going to expand your network. And so parties are that perfect option because they get you in front of people. Now, this is the thing with parties. If you want to be successful at parties, you need to be doing those parties. You can't just be throwing up pictures of random people, okay? That is not going to help them to connect with you. It's not going to help them learn from you, okay? Because they're not your results. You could just be taking a picture and photoshopping it or making it up, right? How many parties have you been into and someone's posted a random before and after or random results and you're like, you're right. You know, I know that's how I am. Like, that is for real how I am. I'm like, whatever. That is not what those results really are. We're naturally skeptical people. But to break down that wall, you got to get out in front of them, okay? And it is scary. It is. It is scary to sit and film yourself on Facebook Live or do a video. But the first time you do it, your heart's going to be pounding. Your palms are going to get sweaty. You might sweat a little. Your breathings might be short. That's how mine was. You might throw up after the video. That's what I did. But you know what? The second time that I did that video, my heart pounded a little bit. My palms got a little sweaty, but I didn't throw up. Why? Because it's like a muscle. And you know, if you haven't gone to the gym in a while, you go to the gym and you're like working out and run, and the next morning like your butt's sore and your legs are sore and you're like, ugh. And so you go the next day and you do it again and you're a little bit sore, but it's not that bad, right? And then by, you know, third or fourth or fifth time that you go to the gym, that soreness is gone. That's the same thing with videos, okay? But you just have to do it. You just got to do it. The worst that can happen is you do it and what? What? Do you, like, what are we really afraid of? What are we really, really, truly afraid of with videos? What are our thoughts? Like, what are some things that you guys are sitting there thinking of? And you're like, oh my gosh, like, I'm so scared to launch because why? Because we're scared of what people are going to think, okay? But we can combat that by branding ourselves with our face. Our face is our brand. We are their makeup girl. That is our brand. Our brand is that we are their go-to makeup girl. And the only way that we can be their go-to makeup girl is if we're going to them with products. And I don't mean going to them physically, I mean virtually. The way that we connect with people online is through videos and pictures, mainly videos though. Video girls who sell, I think Younique actually, when I had just joined, Younique had done like, I don't remember where I heard it or where I saw it, but they said that girls who did videos as opposed to girls who didn't had more than double the sales of the girls who didn't do videos. So the girls who were doing videos of themselves consistently were having more than double the sales, okay? Now let's talk about videos. Let's talk about some easy ways, because videos are scary. So let's talk about some ways that we can ease into videos, that we can get ourselves comfortable with videos, okay? So the first one, Facebook Live is really scary, but I think unboxing a kit on Facebook Live is easier to do because it's just kind of like, you're just like, oh my gosh, like, this is so cute. You guys, look at how pretty this palette is. Like, oh my gosh, I am obsessed with that. And you can stick your finger in it. You can put it on your wrist and show them like that. But if you get stuck, then you just move on to the next product. And then when you're done, be like, oh my gosh, I cannot believe how much stuff I got. Like, that is insane. All right, guys, well, I'm going to go and I'll show you guys stuff later. You know, you can end it like that. So when you get stuck, you can just move on to the next thing. Okay, so if that is just too much for you, then do this, okay? First video that you're going to want to do is, it is going to be of you, okay? It's going to be of you. It's going to be an easy video. So maybe like showing how the cream shadow shimmers, okay? Or showing how the concealer covers. What I did for mine was I have this, and just pretend that, hold on, I'll draw on my arm real quick. Okay, pretend that this was my tattoo, right? Okay, so I set my phone up, and so I don't say anything at all, okay? If your first video, just don't even have to say anything at all. First tutorial, I should say. You don't say anything at all. You grab the product that you're using, pretend this is liquid foundation, product that you're using, show this, okay? You dab it, and then cover one side of it, and just, okay? And then you can go back in, and you can, like, maybe add a picture, or add, you know, just, like, a picture, or, and some text, and you can add some music, and that's it. A 30-second video showing how you covered half of a tattoo. Or, if you don't have a tattoo, draw hard on your hand. Cover that with the concealer. That works, too. Or a permanent marker, okay? That shows them something. That shows them, hey, I know that girl. I know that girl. And those are the results she got. I bet those are the results I can get too. Okay? Now, just because you post one video doesn't mean that they're necessarily going to jump, chase you down, and buy from you. But you're going to be on their mind. And that's why consistency pays off. The girls who are doing videos and who are consistent have the highest sales in the entire company. Because they don't stop. They don't let a few day period of where they're not getting sales slow them down, okay? So that's going to be your first video. So your first video, you are just literally going to film yourself something simple. You want to show how the splurge cream shadow is shimmery? You just show the splurge cream shadow, show your hand, take it out, swipe it on, do like this, show it back and forth, and then like that, and then you can use my picture of all the other cream shadows and then add some text and some music. Boom, that's a video. You did a video. You were in it, okay? And that's how you start easing yourself into video. So then the second video that you're going to do is going to be another simple one. Concealer, splurge cream shadow. What else is easy? Maybe, you know, foundation, cover, you know, foundation. Primer and no primer. You can use the sample in your... presenter kit. You can put primer on one side, no primer on the other. Take your palette and your brush, dip it in, show how this side's light, and then with the primer side, it's super, super dark. You don't have to say anything, okay? And then what you can do for that second video is the same thing, except you can go back in and add a voiceover. Because if you mess up, well, who cares? And you just delete it and try it again, right? And that gets you more comfortable. It starts working the way that you are getting accustomed to videos, okay? So then that third video that you're going to do is you're going to prop yourself up and film yourself, and you're going to film yourself, and you're going to do a quick, easy one, but you're going to talk through this one, okay? And if you need help with this, message me and let me know. And for this one, maybe do mascara, okay? And I can help you speed it up. You can say, all right, so the first thing that we're going to do is one step of the gel, and we're just going to, you know, bottom to the tops of our lashes. Immediately after, we're going to do fibers from middle of the lash to the tip, just like that, okay? And you can talk through that one. You can verbalize that one. And to make it more fun and upbeat, add a little bit of music. You can just add some music, and we can add maybe some pictures in or something like that, okay? So that's going to be the third or fourth video, whatever one we're on. Okay, so then the next video that you're going to do is you're going to work on getting that energy level up, okay? So you're going to take your energy level from here, and you're going to get excited. You're going to talk like this, and this is how you're going to film yourself, and you're going to feel really, really ridiculous, but it works, okay? See how I did that? See how you were like, oh, wait, let me pay attention to her right there. That is how you translate. You got to get that energy level up, but you don't have to do it perfect. You don't have to be perfect on your first video. No one was perfect on their first video. My first video, I looked like this. I didn't have any makeup on. And I welcomed them right there. I was so scared, y'all, that I had to have my daughter and my dog be in the video with me. But I still did it. I was terrified, and I threw up afterwards, and I couldn't even sit there and do it by myself. I literally had to have my dog come in and be in the video with me. But I still did it. And you know what? Now, videos ain't no thing. I was terrified before. Absolutely terrified. But I did it anyway. And that's the thing. When you're launching, of course you're going to be scared. We're all scared. Even those of us who are Sherry Brown, Black Status Mastery Millionaire Level 2, she still started somewhere, okay? And if you scroll all the way back 4 years ago and you watch her beginning videos, they weren't great, okay? But you get better, you learn. The only way that you're going to be able to be successful in this business is you got to go. You just got to do it, okay? So now, I did take a couple notes on what I did to get myself to yellow, because yellow is all about PRS, personal retail sales, okay? And it's about $1,000 in personal retail sales. And the cool thing with yellow is that once you hit that yellow mark, first off, you're halfway to fast start, which is a $250 shopping spree. Second of all, you get a 25% commission bump. So you go from 20 to 25% and you'll never drop down below that, okay? So yellow is a big deal. It's a big deal. You want to get to yellow, okay? So the first thing that, and a lot of you have done this, but we're going to go through this just in case anyway. Okay, so one of the first things that I did is when I had first joined, my picture was of like me and my kids, or maybe it was my dog or something. So you remember, we're the go-to makeup girl. So I did my makeup. I took a selfie. I stood in front of the window. Stand in front of the window like you're facing out of it. Hold the picture in front of you. Play with the lighting. Rotate yourself. Have whatever you got to do. And I took a picture and I made that my main profile picture. Okay? I wanted the first thing when people see Ashley Haynes Champion commented on something, I want that little icon picture. I want it to be me with makeup on. Okay? So I changed my profile picture to me. The second thing that I did was I edited my bio. And it said that I was a white status presenter at Actually Lashley with Ashley. That's what it was. I didn't say Younique Corporate because we don't work for Younique Corporate. We work for us, okay? The third thing that I did was I made a VIP group. I added my friends, and I filmed a 1 minute long, 60 second long welcome video. I just said, hey, you guys, thank you so much for joining my party. And then Roscoe licked my face, and I was like, I'm sorry. I was like, I am really excited to have you guys on this journey with me. I have joined Younique. I absolutely love their products. And I am really excited to be able to show you guys the different types of results that you can get with these products. You can expect lots of pictures from me, lots of videos of me. And this is going to be kind of our go-to beauty group. So if you have any friends that you'd like to add, feel free to add them. And thank you so much for hanging out with me. That was it. 30, 60 seconds. That was it. I did my welcome video, and it was terrible, okay? Like, I'm embarrassed to go back and even watch it. It's still on my VIP page. If y'all want to see it, go scroll all the way down to the bottom. Go hit info, photos, and scroll all the way down. It was terrible, okay? I didn't have any makeup on. I was like stuttering. I was clammy. You could tell I was nervous. My voice was shaky, but I still did it, okay? And you know what? People didn't think I was annoying. People didn't, they didn't make fun of me because they're like, hey, whoa, Ashley's trying something new. Like, she didn't normally try new stuff like that. That's cool. Hey, Ashley didn't really wear makeup that often, and she's doing this. Like, I'm kind of interested to see. People are nosy, okay? People want to, they want to know what you're doing. They want to know what you're up to. They want to do what you're doing. That's just how people are. So you play into that by connecting with them through your pictures and your videos, okay? So I changed my bio to say Actually Lashley with Ashley. I started posting in my VIP group. So I posted that welcome. And then I did a kit buildup. So when I got my shipping confirmation from Younique in my email, I screenshot that, and then I took a picture of me, and I was like that. I mean, goofy, no makeup still, and I was like that, and I collaged the two together in the layouts app, and I said, I was like, oh my gosh, I just got my shipping confirmation. It'll be here within the next couple days. I am so excited. What do you guys want to see first? Okay? And you know what? Nobody commented. Nobody commented. So what did I do? Mom, sister, grandma, go like and comment that post that I just did in my VIP page. And they were like, okay, cool. And then they started commenting and liking, and I replied to them. And then people started commenting, okay? So I was boosting my Facebook algorithm. Maybe I had to twist my mom and my sister's arm a little bit, but who cares? Who cares? You know, I'll comment on it. Post it anyway. If nobody comments on it, your sponsor will comment on it. Your girlfriends from your team will comment on it, okay? That is what we are here for, is to help build you up. Nobody starts off being successful. Nobody goes in and just knows how to do videos perfectly. Nobody goes in and takes the perfect selfie. Nobody goes in and knows how to do makeup flawlessly, okay? I didn't even wear makeup before. So believe me when I say, I didn't know how to apply, okay? I knew nothing. If you look at my makeup from when I first started to now, it's like, whoa. Like, but you know what? People still bought from me when I first started. And they were along with me for this journey because it was always me. They could see what I was getting better at, okay? They could see what I was improving on. They could see what I was changing, what I was doing, and that intrigued them. But I was always consistent, and I started. I did it even though I was terrified, okay? And that's the key, is you just gotta do it, okay? So another thing that I did in my VIP group was I didn't have any half-off items, okay, but I knew I was going to get them because I was determined to, right? So I said, add a friend, tag them in this post. I think I took a selfie of me, and I was like that, and it was like, I think I went in WordSwag, and it was like, earn a free half-off item, and it was a add your friend to this group and tag them in this post, and I'll enter you both to win a free half-off. And I built my VIP group, you know, I think like 50 or 60 people were in that group just from that. And it got the people commenting, okay, which boosted my algorithm. Another thing that I did was I shared the welcome that my sponsor created on my wall. So I just, you know, I shared it and I just basically announced that I was being a presenter, and people liked it, and they were excited about it, okay? They were like, wow, Ashley's trying something new. Cool, can't wait. Even if they weren't legitimately interested in it, they were interested in what I was doing, okay? And when people, I've had so many girls sit back and watch, and they see, oh my gosh, Ashley got a promotion, or oh my gosh, her sponsor shouting her out for this, or oh my gosh, like, she just got a pay raise, like, huh? And people think, they might not like, they might not comment, but they think about it, okay? And that's again, goes with your branding and your face, okay? If they see you doing it, it makes them stop and think. Another thing that I did to help get myself up to yellow was I posted 4 times a day on my main wall. One of those 4 posts was Younique. The rest of it was pictures of my kids, my dogs, me, something funny. I always kept it positive. I was super, super negative before. I was going through really bad postpartum anxiety, and I just had a lot of stuff that I was struggling with. But I knew how it felt when someone was constantly negative, and that's annoying. You know, think of the person on your Facebook wall that you scroll, and no matter what they post, it is just always a Debbie Downer post, and you're like, ugh, okay, you don't want to be that person. So you don't necessarily want to be fake, but you can take a negative situation and turn it into something relatable. So for instance, instead of saying, like, pretend I got a flat tire, oh my gosh, like another flat tire, like, can anything else possibly go wrong, okay? That is just going to get like keep me away from her, right? Or I could take a picture of me with my makeup and be like that. And then the downside is that my tire's flat and I have no idea how to change it. But the upside is that my lipstick is popping, okay? see how that people still connected with me though on that first tidbit because they're like, oh man, flat tire. I just got one of those, or I don't know how to change one of those either. Okay. So that's the way, that's the type of stuff that you're going to learn as you go into this. But you're not going to learn it by watching. You're not going to learn it by watching me or watching someone else. You're going to learn by doing. Okay. This business is all about doing. You will get better at the things that you do, at the things that you practice. If you want to be really awesome at parties, guess what you got to do? You got to do a lot of parties. If you want to be really awesome at selling, guess what you got to do? You got to do a lot of pictures. You got to do a lot of videos. Videos, really. If you want to be really good at sponsoring, guess what you got to do? You got to do a lot of parties and videos because that is what people are going to connect with you with. People don't join people. People don't join businesses. People join people, okay? People don't join businesses. They don't join products. They don't fall in love with products. They fall in love with the person and the results that they're getting, okay? So another thing that I did to get to yellow is I launched. I did my launch. I got my kit, and I was like, all right, one day I'm going to do mascara. The next day I'm going to do eyeshadow palette. Next day I'm going to do lip stains or liquid matte lipsticks or whatever. Next, one day I'm going to do skincare, night cream, detox mask, okay? And I made sure that in my VIP launch group, I hosted 3 times a day, but I had it each day, like day 1 was mascara, day 2 was lip stain, day 3 was night cream, day 4 was eyeshadow palettes, okay? I didn't know how to put that stuff on. I had no idea how to put that stuff on, but I did it. I did it anyway, okay? Always pictures and videos of me, never graphics. We went over that. And, the next thing that I did to get myself to yellow is I knew after my launch party, I was like, okay, I've gone through my warm market. Who's going to buy from me, but now I've got to expand. So then I went to those customers and I asked them to host a party for me. I got a ton of no's. Okay. I asked like 400 people last month to host a party for me. I got like 360 no's, but I got 40 yeses, okay? So, starting a new business is scary. Starting anything new is scary, okay? But the only way to break through that fear is to just do it. You just got to do it. If there's something that you are really, really scared about, message me. Let's talk about it, okay? Sometimes just verbalizing your fears out loud just helps, okay? And if it's something that you are just absolutely terrified in, let's work together, okay? That's why I'm here. That is why you girls signed up under me, so I can hold your hand and walk you through this process, okay? That is what my sponsor did with me, and had she not held my hand, I would not be where I am today. So I am fully prepared to do some hand-holding, all right? So I hope this was helpful. It was a little bit impromptu, but I just felt like there was just, you know, it was just like something that, you know, we just needed to hear. So if there's any specific training that you guys would like to hear me talk on, please message me and let me know. I would absolutely love to accommodate that. That's all I have for this particular topic. If I think of anything else, I will add it to the comments. All right, ladies, bye.